Disease fighting in modern medicine is often a game of whack-a-mole. Just when you think you've solved one disease, a new problem comes up to take its place. Take, for example, infectious disease from bacteria, fungus, and other parasites. 100 years ago, that was one of the main ways people died. Deaths from those types of infections are significantly down, thanks to the relatively sterile world we live in. Washing your hands with antibacterial soaps, FDA-regulated foods, antibiotics, and you realize the world we live in is a really clean one. Unless, of course, you're watching this video on the toilet in your bathroom, then you probably want to clean your phone afterwards. With antibacterial wipes, of course. But here's the problem. While the rate of death from infections is going down, the rate of autoimmune disorders is on the rise. Type 1 diabetes, asthma, allergies, Crohn's, and such disorders are becoming more and more common. Disorders where your own immune system begins to attack your body. And the NIH estimates that up to 23.5 million Americans currently suffer from autoimmune disorders. And that proposes the question, why the increase? If we take a look at where the autoimmune disorders occur, they mostly strike in the developed world, especially among the more affluent, sparing farms and rural areas. You are more likely to have a disease like Crohn's living in New York City than living on a farm, with some studies finding that farm-raised individuals are protected against such issues. What's even more striking is that places like Nepal, where parasitic infections with worms is widespread, these type of autoimmune inflammatory disorders are rather rare to come by. That's where the old friends hypothesis comes to answer this predicament. As we've created a cleaner, more sterile world, safe from the harms of infectious organisms, we've exposed ourselves to attacks from our own immune system. The immune system isn't having to attack as many foreign invaders, and instead is attacking our own bodies. These old friends, bacteria, worms, and parasites that have evolved with human beings for thousands of years have become vital in training our immune systems. Scientists have found that in more sterile, urban environments, the incidence of regulatory T cells which control our immune systems from attacking ourselves is far less than in their rural counterparts, suggesting that these organisms train the immune system in our gut as we eat. There was no antibacterial soap 10,000 years ago. Kids play video games rather than in the dirt, and being clean is the norm. And with the absence of these organisms in our diets, the immune system of some individuals have begun to run wild, attacking their own bodies in the lack of training from foreign organisms. This results in a higher number of Th1 and Th2 T cells that initiate an immune response instead of the regulatory T cells that suppress the immune system from self-harm. While it may sound gross to have worms inside of us, most of these organisms aren't all too harmful, as we have adaptations, such as IgE antibodies, to protect us. And since you're thinking it, yes, doctors have tried to heal people with worms, called Helminth Therapy, by feeding people worm eggs and letting them hatch inside of them, with some mixed results. If that wasn't disgusting for you, fecal transplants from donors with good bacteria are given to people with these inflammatory disorders such as Crohn's, in hopes that these super poop donors can help the inflammation subside, with some surprisingly good results. And I'm sure you've heard of the rising trend of taking probiotics, whether in capsules or in yogurt, with the theory that consuming good bacteria can help strengthen and regulate the immune system. The microflora is now a field of much research, so the jury's still out on what possible benefits there can be from this. I'll have a video about that very soon. So don't go out and eat a worm or take a poop sample from someone, please. Dr. Stickfigure is not responsible in any way for any ideas you get from this video, such as eating worms. Any worms eating should be done on the supervision of a doctor. Thank you for watching. I hope this video was helpful. Please subscribe to my channel if you'd like more videos and follow me on social media to keep in touch. By the way, I had a worm infection as a kid and it wasn't all too bad. Let me know what experiences you guys have had in the comments.